Hello everyone, this is me Sadia here and I'm doing your first week of January reading starting from the 1st through the 7th of January 2021. This is going to be for the sign of Aquarius, so it's your is coming up for you guys for the first week time. I will be adding oracle cards in this reading but no charms will be added, so yeah, stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you it's a general reading, it may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. So yeah, let's begin the reading and let's find out what is coming up for the equipments for the first week of January time. Let's see. The Wheel of Fortune. Things are changing, things are shifting for you in your life, and for majority of you, I feel like, you know, a lot of abundance is entering in your life, financial one. I feel like, you know, you are going to, you know, this time from now to the summertime, so many things are going to happen in your life, you know, sudden shifts, sudden changes, sudden endings, beginnings, all is going to happen for you from now till the summertime. It's gonna be like, you know, very fast-paced life for you as well in this time from now to the maybe the first half of the year is going to be a lot of bringing you a lot of changes. For some of you, the changes that you are going to be triggering this time is going to impact your life till the June July time is what I'm picking up. Let's see more cards here. Empress. For some of you, you will be starting a new connection with someone, and that connection could lead towards marriage with that specific someone by the summertime. If you're starting a new relationship with someone, I feel like, you know, you have a strong chance of getting married to this person by the summertime for sure. And let's see more cards here. Knight of Swords, King of Pentacles. There would be a bit of a, you know, age gap between the two of you for sure. Like either one of you is going to be more mature as the other one. I do see, you know, maturity as an age, not otherwise. Maybe you know, nature wise maybe you would be same, but there is going to be age gap between the two of you. The age difference could be big enough for the two of you. Maybe for some of you, maybe it's going to be 7 to 10 years old, you know, 10 years difference, age difference. But I do see that, you know, this connection is going to mature this other person. For some of you, this is going to be a twin flame journey that you're going to start with this person. But I feel like, you know, for some reasons, if the age gap is, you know, bigger than 10 years, maybe the connection is not going to last. So whatever changes that are happening right now till, you know, the June, July time, you know, that, you know, I feel like, you know, the changes are triggered this time. And like I said, the decisions, the decisions that you are taking right now is going to impact your life for long term. It's going to affect your life for long term. I feel like, you know, if there is age difference between the two of you, then I don't see this connection last long. I feel like, you know, it's gonna end. Let's see more cards here. Yes, because I feel like, you know, in that situation, the decision that is taken right now, it's not gonna be something which the younger person is going to feel the need to put more effort into. You know, I feel like, you know, whoever is younger in this situation, that person is going to end the connection, be that a masculine or be that the feminine in this connection. I feel like, you know, the younger is going to end this connection, and maybe if you get married to this person right now, maybe the connection is going to end around the summertime. You know, I do see something that is triggered right now. Maybe for some of you, you might be getting married to this person because of the money situation, to increase your money situation or to improve your money situation. If that's happening, I feel like, you know, that could be the reason why. Maybe you are going to get the money that you wanted with this person, and then you are going to leave this person because that was the only intention behind getting married to this person. So I do see some, you know, that kind of shifts happening for you. For some of you, maybe this has already happened, and if that's the case, I feel like, you know, you will be Hold on, if that's has that has happened. If this is something that has already happened for you, then I feel like the one who is left alone now after your person walked away from you, I feel like you would be ready to have a new beginning in your life now. If this cycle has already happened for you in the last year, maybe now is the time when you are choosing to move on with the new person in your life, and now you are choosing to choose somebody who is mature enough, who's stable enough financially, so you don't have a fear of losing that person again for the same reason. Because I feel like you are not ready now to invest into a wrong connection this time around. You have done that in the past. You learned your lesson, and now you don't want to deal with anything like that. Like something that happened before. So I feel like if you have married somebody once, you are choosing to get married to another person this time, the second person this time, and I feel like this time it's gonna be you're not gonna get married to this person until and unless this person proves themselves for you to be the one for them. It's more like that situation where you have you are mature enough and you have dealt with the same situation before as well. So you are very very careful with taking a love life decision now because of the past experience that you had with the wrong person. And for some of you, maybe you are not going to give this connection a chance that easily. You're gonna take your time to decide because you do see the same maybe age difference between the two of you, and then you feel like, what if this person does the same to you? But this time, this person, whoever it is that you're getting now, this person too is financially stable. But and maybe they have been hurt in the past. Maybe for some reasons, maybe you and your person, whoever it is that you're meeting now, they have experience the same kind of past. Maybe somebody married them for their money as well. If that has been the case, then it's gonna be a perfect match. But I feel like, still you're gonna take your time to decide. But yes, I do see that this person has a potential to give you what you want. If it is the second time you're getting married, the new person that you are having, be that the age difference is gonna still work out well for you. If this is the first person that you are getting married, I feel like this marriage is not going to last long. Because there is the lesson that you need to learn in this situation. For the people who are getting married first time, I feel like especially if you have the age difference, because this reading is not going to match with the ones who don't have the age gap or age difference. So just be mindful of that. Just pick whatever is resonating with you in your situation and leave the rest. And but I do see, if it's a second marriage, it's gonna work out. Let's see what the oracle has to add. Conclusions are within reach. I feel like, I completely concluded the whole situation here for you already. What has happened, what needs to be done to have a future that is stable enough. So go for that. But again, for some of you, maybe you will be getting the conclusions around the situation. What is going to be the good for you, good decision for you, and what is not. So I feel like, eventually you are going to learn your own lesson, and that's how you are going to make your new choice in whatever area it applies to. Let's see. Healthy lifestyle, eat a healthful diet, get adequate sleep, and exercise regularly for optimal health. It's very important to take care of your health right now. Especially if for some of you might have basically if especially if it's a second marriage for you, maybe for some of you have just gotten yourself into unhealthy lifestyle. You really need to start eating healthy and take proper have proper self-care routine. Then we do have abundance. I do see financial abundance, but I do see lack of happiness from within. Coming, that you would be having. So make sure whatever you choose to do in your love life, make sure it brings you happiness, emotional fulfillment, along with the financial abundance too. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this reading. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye bye.